Hello, hello, this is Anna Santos and welcome to our 100 tips on how to make money online. Question, what will I do if this pandemic and this crisis happened 4 years ago and I was left with no job, no savings, and no business? Anyway, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe and like and share. Who knows, you might help someone else, okay? I believe, no? That crisis is the incubator of innovation. A lot of my friends is prospering during this crisis. A lot of my friends started business during this crisis. Why? It's because they don't have a choice but to go out of their comfort zone. And then they realize that, oh my, I have a gift with this. I am gifted with selling this item. I am gifted with PR. I am gifted with this skill. So, doon nila na-discover na meron pala silang skill nung crisis. Kasi, at that time, they're working on a secure job and they haven't thought of going out of their comfort zone. But during crisis, kasi nga, crisis and they don't have a choice, they went out and they discovered the skills that they haven't discovered during the time that they are working for someone else. Okay? So, crisis for me is not bad at all. You know, my business started because of crisis. When I resigned from my job and, you know, I wala po akong pambayad ng kuryente, nag-isip ako magbenta. So, that's what crisis can do. Okay? And they discover also that they have this business acumen. Okay? Because of crisis. So, the question is, what would I do if I would start again? If this pandemic happened and this crisis happened 4 years ago and I was left with no job, no savings, and no business. Number one is I would sell my favorite. Okay? Napakadaling ibenta kasi paborito mo nga eh. Di po ba? Kung paborito mo, like for example, may paborito ko, Japanese food, sushi, sashimi, yun ang ibenta ko. Kasi I know the quality. Kinakain ko madalas. So napakadaling i-upsell. Okay? When I was working in a hotel, when I was working with Shangri-La, ang lagi kong ina-upsell ay yung mga bagay na kinakain ko talaga, yung mga bagay na paborito ko. Oh, well, that's my personal favorite. Okay? And also, yung mga bagay na paborito ng anak ko. The things that they love to eat, okay? Yun ang mga binibenta ko. Kasi, personally, I would not sell, lalong-lalo na sa food, I would not sell something if my kids won't eat it. Kung ayaw nilang kainin, ba't ko ibibenta sa iba? Di ba? So, hindi ako magbibenta ng mga bagay na hindi ko kinakain at hindi kakainin ng anak ko. Also, I would sell the things that I use frequently. Like, for example, if I'm using this parang liquid cream that's coming from Korea, tapos hindi siya readily available in Australia, I get it from Korea, so I would sell that too. Kasi, madaling ibenta. Ang proof mo mismo nasa mukha mo. Look at my face. Oh, ganun, di ba? Look at my face. Ang kinis because of this. Okay? Yung cream na to ang ginagamit ko. So, napakadaling ibenta. Okay? So, that's the first one that I would do. I would sell my favorites or I would sell the things that I frequently use that is not readily available in your local store. Second, I will sell my expertise. So, like for example, at the moment, as running Facebook advertising for clients, I run sponsored ads for them. That's what, ayan yung isang bagay na gagawin ko. Ibebenta ko yung aking service, ang aking expertise to other people. Okay? Because a lot of us, I believe lahat po tayo may gift. Lahat po tayo may uniqueness. Nung pinanganak po tayo sa mundo, God injected us with a gift. Okay? God injected us with a gift. So, kung hindi mo pa na-discover yon, yun ang isa sa pinakamalaking assignment na dapat mong malaman. What is your gift? Okay? So, I would sell my expertise. If you're expert in, like for example, website designing, then sell that. If, like for example, you are expert in marketing, then find a way to monetize that. Okay, if like for example me, because I have kahit paano expertise in social media management, I will sell that. Okay, now there are things ano na pwede mong gawin. Like for example, you don't have the expertise, you don't have the expertise just yet, but you know someone who can do that for you. pwede mong gawin din yon. Ang tawag po doon is digital arbitrage, which I did in the past few years. Okay? So, those are the things na pwede mong gawin kung ikaw ay nag-iisip sa ngayong pandemic, ngayong crisis, at hindi mo alam paano kumita ng extra. Number one is sell your favorites. Number two is sell your expertise. Maraming maraming salamat po and see you again on Monday!